Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Hey fish family, welcome back to Tabarak Aquatics. I am Ross, and you're down here in my fish room. I just got home from work, and I'm very excited. I got a shipment sent to me, and what I have is some rescues slash purchase that I got from Predatory Fins. Hold tight, and I'll show you what I got. Fish family, I got my tools. I think I got my tools. All right, got my box cutter here. I got my fish nets and stuff, my buckets. Let's go ahead and open this up and see what we got. I'm a little nervous because these are some rather large size fish, and we did all of this under special circumstances. I'm going to be optimistic. This box cutter is so sharp. I swear it is. Let's see what we have. I'm so excited. Sorry guys if I'm boring the crap out of y'all with all this extra footage. But let's see what we got. Let's see. Okay, got a heat pack in here. Okay, I see some movement. Let's see what we have here. Okay family, I'm trying to get close. I hope that you guys can see, but if you look on the top of the Zebrina pikes, look on the top of their nose, on top of their head, you can see the hole in the head. The lenticulata pike is, you can barely see it. It's like on the side of his body right there. But in any case, for the price that I paid as far as buying them at cost and the shipping, I am not angry at all. I'm not mad at all. I thought they were going to be in really bad shape, and they're not. So what I got them in here, I'm going to call this a stream acclimation, not quite a drip acclimation, a stream acclimation. I'm acclimating them a little faster than just a drip because I don't want the discomfort as far as the temperature and the the ammonia. I did put in some Seeking Prime to neutralize the ammonia, and I got a Aerostone in here creating oxygen, and I'm about to put in some Seeking Stress Guard in here as well. But I'm gonna slow the stream down just a little bit and go ahead and acclimate them and put them in this tank right here to quarantine. I had just took my female jaguar out there and put her in the other quarantine tank with the male jaguar. If they can get along in that little tank without fighting, I'll keep them in there for another week or so. If not, then I'll just put them, because really they healed up from what I was worried about, but I just want to keep them in there just in case. But I had to, like, I got to put these guys somewhere. So hopefully the three of these guys right here will quarantine all right in that tank right there, because space is kind of tight. And the other fish that I have quarantining and growing out, I don't want to disturb their groove or whatever. But in any case, I think this is a great haul right here. I got two more Zebrina pikes and another lenticulata pike that I'm going to grow out and put in the big predator tank. So now I got to decide which fish in the predator tank that I'm going to take out and rehome. All right, y'all. All right, fish family, look at here. Here we are. About 3 days later. What is today? Is Sunday? Let me see. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Yeah. So 3 days later, this is how they look. I had to pull the sponge filter out because they were hiding behind it. They're not quite comfortable yet. Sorry for all the detritus in here that come from me pulling out the sponge filter. Today I'm going to go to the hardware store, get some more PVC pipes, and put in here for them to, hide in, to feel comfortable, whatever. But as you can see, if you're looking closely at their heads, the hole in the head situation is really not that bad. They actually look a little better today than they looked when I unboxed them on Thursday. So what I did was I just simply put some salt in here and did a water change day before yesterday. So today I'm going to do another water change, put some aquarium salt in here, and maybe I might put some metro in here, or just put some stress guard in here. I don't want to overdo it because I think they would do well with big water changes, often water changes, and some aquarium salt. I don't want to overdo it because they just getting in here, getting used to my water and my conditions. But yeah, I'll take that. I think this was a good pickup. This was a good buy. I'm not upset about this at all. Okay, and I put the lenticulata pipe in a different quarantine, one of the tubs, because I found that even though he's smaller than these two, he was a bit aggressive towards them, just nagging them. So I put him by himself, and I think I'm going to approach him with just some aquarium salt as well and see how that come out. And here's my big Zebrina pike. Now, he looked pretty much like them when I first got him. So I'm looking forward to fattening those guys up and getting them looking real colored up and fat and beautiful like this guy here. You can see he got a little white scrape on his side. He chases all the fish around because he's the new king of the tank, or the new tank boss, while the jaguars are still in quarantine. We'll see how that hold up when I put the jaguar cichlids back in here. But that's what we got. That's what we're expecting out of those two that I have down there, for them to develop and get as beautiful like this guy here. And this lenticulata pike was even smaller than the one that I have, but this is what we can expect out of the lenticulata pike, God willing, for him to get fat and beautiful, healthy looking like this guy here. Not like that photobomber, but like that lenticulata pike right there. This red pike here, I've been treating him for holding the head. As you can see, it's starting to color up, filling with color in those sore spots or whatever. I've been putting metro in his food, but I noticed that since I have been doing more water changes, more often frequent water changes in here, and I did change the pH. I put some of that crushed coral in a bag, in a mesh bag, and throw it in the sump. I think the pH has something to do with it, because that's when he really started, when I really started seeing the difference in him coloring up and those spots filling in. And just for good measure, this guy came in to photobomb because he know he is the most beautiful red pike on the planet. So he had to come in. I don't know if it's a he or a she, but he had to come in to photobomb. So I went on and included him. All right, fish family, tell me what you think. Was that a good rescue or not? Basically what I did was Rod offered those fish to me, the two Zebrina pikes, at his cost or whatever. And that was because the hole in the head that I have to treat, and he don't want to sell me any fish that's sick or anything like that. So we made a deal. He sold me those fish at cost, and he threw in a lenticulata pike along with it. So basically, he and I agreed to call it a rescue. So I call it a rescue because that was, I'm not even going to share the price with you as far as the cost. But so what you guys think? Good pickup or not? Worthwhile rescue? I say yes, but y'all let me know what you think in the comments. Well, thank you for joining me. Again, if you have not subscribed to this channel, please go ahead and subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can be updated every time I drop a video. Please leave a comment, leave a like, and thank you very much for sticking with me. Until next time, happy fish keeping, happy water keeping. As you can see, I'm keeping water now. I'm doing a water change, filling the tank. All right,
Happy fish keeping. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.